Meet the Expert, a knowledge-sharing initiative of your knowledge partner, the Developing Bangladesh. We discuss on trade, investment, commerce, education, skills, economic development, global peace and prosperity, etc. issues. If you are interested to these issues, please subscribe to the channel. Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner, please subscribe now.
Yes, I saw my teacher presented it in this way. I will follow him up. Then my student will follow me up. My student's student will follow me and my grand teacher up. So all this traditional method of education should be changed. Yes, this is particularly regarding your delivery issues. So at this moment, I would like to just ask you a basic questions regarding South Asian education in Bangladesh. I can give you Bangladeshi example. We have Bengali medium education. We have English version of Bengali medium education. That's, we have English medium education. We have Arabic medium education, that's Madrasa education. Inside the Madrasa education, we have some Qaumis, called Qaumi Madrasa. We have some General Aliya Madrasa. Inside, we have some Hifs, other religion. And we have science, arts, commerce, these particular groupings inside the education system. So all this education system, when I became a bachelor degree holder or a master degree holder, I'm confused what I started learning in my primary school and what I just left in my master degree syllabus and what message or what I have learned. So regarding all these different system of education, this different line of education, I'm sure that Nepal, you have also this sort of different dimensions of education. So what is your recommendation regarding these dimensions, how we can produce fruitful or productive graduates from all these avenues?
So first of all, every group has their own way of education for a reason. For a child who has never been exposed to an English medium school, getting exposed to it all of a sudden is a challenge in itself and stuff like that. Now, regarding how, let's come to a few things. Number one, language barrier, right? I think the principles of education remain same as long as the teachers can, again, have the right delivery, have the right content, and know how to confront students in the right way. I think the education quality at the end of the day comes in. However, I personally, this is my personal belief, that English is an important skill to learn. You know, in South Asia, English is not just a language, but something beyond that, because it gives you access to a lot of other things, right? A kid who has never made, whose parents have never made more than, you know, $150 in a month, if he can learn English, if he can learn how to use a computer, he can make 10 times that money in a single month if he knows how to do it in the right way, you know. And it is impossible if he does not know English. I won't say it's impossible, it's very difficult if he does not know English in the first place. So I do believe English has its own space, but the principles of education remain the same. First of all, objectives must be decided. Let's say there's a madrasa school over there or Indian Vedic school over there. Why the school students are going to the school might be very different to why a private school student is going to the school or why a government school student is going to go to the school. A government school student goes to the school so that he can find a job after 10th grade, you know, while a private one might go for that, but his expectation of his income might be very different, you know. So there are a lot of variations into concepts like this, but defining their own KPIs, you know, key performance indicators. What are the key performance indicators of my education? Why I'm sending my students to the school? What the school stands for? And if it is delivering up to that, I think it's all good.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I know you have another program just after this one. So I am cutting down my two questions in a single question. What is the best way of education around the globe you have ever observed? And what is the worst way of education system in the planet? I would like to know your experience of these 54 countries. What is the best one system? What is the worst one?
I think I would be polarizing. Okay, so here's the thing. Education is not an independent thing. It comes down to the respective culture as well. Finnish education system is amazing, but it might not at all work if I bring it just as it is to Nepal because of how teachers and parents and different stakeholders function outside the boundaries of the school. I found the Finnish education system amazing in terms... Let me give you what I found amazing in 4 to 5 different countries. I love Japan's education system because the kids are given a lot of room for independence over there. You know, there's a lot of room for independence over there. I love the Vedic schools in India because students learn principles of personal excellence, self-development, you know, and stuff like that. I love the Norwegian education system because it diversifies students after a certain grade. If this skill student is meant to be an academician or if it is going to help learn technical skills and then be sent to polytechnic schools. And this happens as well in Singapore. But in Singapore, the other critical thing is if a kid is not going to the school after a certain age, the parents are criminals and they are going to go to jail for it. So it's a mandatory thing over there. And also how the polytechnical schools function in Singapore is mind-blowing. And I love that, you know. And usually in countries like South Asia, polytechnical schools are a stigma that if students cannot do well, they go to these schools. But over there, these are amazing places to go. And then coming down to Finland, which is probably the top or the top three in the list for me, is how the curriculum works, the trust that is bestowed upon the teachers, and at the same time, how the entire ecosystem has been functioning so well. So I think these are some insights. I have worked with students from 54 countries, but I've only been personally to 3 to 4 countries, and all of these other countries have been able to work virtually with the students over there. So I think I'm myself in a journey of exploration of education system. And what I say right now might change over time as well, because I am personally, I'm in a learning journey as well. So yeah, that's how it is.
Wonderful. You are a fan of education system is Finland. Yes, we all just by this time recognize. Yes, myself, I'm also listen about the education system and how it works, how it is relevant with their daily life, practical life in their profession. So it is a wonderful one. In South Asia or Asian countries, you have rightly pointed out Singapore and Japan. These are very, very important. In some cases, Indian education system is doing better, but in general, it is like Bangladesh or Nepal. It is almost similar. And Norwegian, I have just listened from you for the first time. So obviously, I would like to explore it further. So with this, I would like to just give you the last voice. That is the most important learning of the session. What is the most important learning of your session, sir?
I think it is to understand how important education is in the first place and what is the motive of education. It is not to create, people who are graduates, but it is about creating people who can make real change in the society. And for that, the objectives of the education need to change. The stakeholders of education and how they perceive about education must be changed. And all of this is going to happen at an individual level. You as a parent can impact by raising voice that my kid is not learning this. You as a teacher can go inside the class and enforce that. You as a principal can literally control the teachers and bring influence. And you as a students can reach out to all of these stakeholders to speak on your behalf and of course raise your voice as well. And it is through these little efforts that we are going to try and bring a more bigger frame of revolution. And I hope we are able to deliver up to the promise of the life our generation, our future generation deserves with the right kind of education.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Actually, these voices, when you raise from Nepal, I talk from Bangladesh, anybody talks from India, Pakistan, and other countries, now South Asian education system will be changed and it will be updated, up to date for meeting up the concurrent demand of the time. With this hope, we would like to conclude today. And obviously, we'll listen from you on another day, maybe on another topic. Till then, stay blessed, stay happy. Being with us and collaborate with developing Bangladesh, it is your real second home. As you start with Bangladesh is your second home. So developing Bangladesh is your second home. Please be with us anytime. Thank you for joining, sir.
Thank you so much for having me. Appreciate you reaching out and glad we could make it.
Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner. We take care of trade and investment, education and skills, economic diplomacy and economic development. If you would like to keep you updated on these issues, please subscribe to Developing Bangladesh. Thank you very much for watching till the last.